So in this video, I'll discuss what is the purpose of 250 ohm resistor at the output of the 420 milliampere transmitter, or it can be at the input of the receiver. So 420 milliampere is commonly used output for the transmitter or the transducer because it has having an advantage of long signal transmission and also is having high noise immunity. So various process signals that are representing the flow level, temperature, pressure, strain, pH, etc. that can be converted to a 420 milliampere, and then it can be connected to the control room. So if you see the 420 milliampere transmitter output, it can be a 2-wire or 3-wire or 4-wire. So finally the transmitter signal is to be converted to a receiver, and the receiver can be a recorder or controller or analog input of PLC or DCS. And if you see at the in the figure controller, so the signal 420 milliampere signal is converted to a voltage by using the resistor, because all these controller record analog input or voltage sensing. So this current signal has to be converted to a voltage by using the high precision resistor. So this is done by using a high precision resistor. So the where the 420 milliampere is converted to a 1 to 5 volts DC. So and that we have seen then this 1 to 5 volts is converted to a digital signal by using an analog to digital converter. So that is an ADC, and then the digital signal then is fed to this CPU, central processing unit, so which will takes the final decision. So for example, if the ADC resolution is 10 bit and if the ADC reference voltage is 5 volts, then resolution of that ADC is 5 millivolts. So in 1 to 5 volts DC, that is corresponding to 4 to 20 milliampere corresponding to 800 steps. So in addition to this voltage conversion, so the resistor is also required so for some other requirement. Suppose if the transmitter is supporting the HART communication, it is one of the field bus which is basic field bus that is supported by all the transmitters. So this HART uses the same 2 wires of conventional 420 milliampere signal for the transmitting the digital data. So digital data this is used in HART following the Bell 202 modem standard. So that transmits the data digital 1 and 0 in terms of the two audio frequency tone. That is 1200 Hz is used for binary bit 1 and 2200 is used for binary bit 2, sorry, binary bit 0. And the data is transferred at a rate of 1200 bits per second, and this uses the frequency shift keying. So if you see the HART signal, so this is an AC signal, so which is having a peak to peak current signal of 1 milliampere. So as this is an AC, the average of AC signal is 0. So this AC that is superimposing on the same 420 milliampere wires will not affect the 420 milliampere DC signal. So one of the important consideration of HART is the total loop resistance should be in the range of 250 ohms to 1100 ohms. So this 250 ohms is easily met by placing the precision resistor for converting the 420 milliampere to 1 to 5 volts. So in the next video, I will make the next video for further discussing about the HART communication basics, and also why this limitation of 250 to 1100 ohms is required for proper HART communication. So this is the HART transmitter block diagram. So this HART transmitter is connected to a HART communicator for troubleshooting or for calibration purpose. So thank you for watching my video.